Hey everybody, welcome to B3 Strength and Performance. Again, my name is Ian. I'm here with Abby. This is not a workout video. This is a mobility and stretch video. We're gonna show you things that you can do prior to exercising, and then this can also be a full day of mobility where you're taking a break from moving and you're just making sure your body is still mobile and has the range of motion that you need. All right, so we're gonna start real simple. We're gonna start from the lower part of the body and then work our way up with rolling and different types of stretches. Abby's going to do your first basic way of rolling, and then I'm going to show you progressive movements where once you get used to the feeling and the pain, reality is it is painful, once you get better and better at it, you can advance those movements a little bit. All right, so we're going to begin with the calves. So what you'll need is a roller. If you don't have a roller, you can probably use any round object, cylinder object, that is hard enough to apply pressure to your joints. You can even use a kettlebell, a barbell. There's just plenty of options. So you can get a broomstick and just roll with the broomstick. So we're gonna start here. Abby's gonna start with both legs on the roller, and then she's gonna elevate her hips by pushing through her hands. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cross one leg over, and now I'm putting even more pressure on one calf. And I like to spend anywhere between 30 to 60 seconds of working. I think that's a good time period for you. The goal here is to find a hard spot, a spot that really hurts, but you're able to breathe through it. If you can't breathe through that hard spot, drop your hips and then just apply your own pressure with your leg. And then if you can, I want you to watch my foot. I'm gonna point my toes. That's where you're really gonna feel it, by pointing the toe. And if you need longer time period, just pause this video, because we're just gonna do this to show you all the different ways you can roll. But what I want you to do is really spend some quality time on it. Now some people, and I'm gonna turn a little bit at an angle. You might angle in your body so they can see a little bit. So some people have more pain at the bottom near the Achilles in their soleus muscle. Other people, it's farther up on the calf. Some people, it's on the inside of the calf. You can also roll and switch it to the outside. And that's where I find all of my tightness. So I hang out here and I hold and I breathe through it. If I'm holding my breath, my muscles won't relax. Again, point the toe and keep moving, flexing at the ankle. All right, once you spent about a minute there, whatever time you chose, switch to the other one. If you've got both calves on there, just stay on there for 60 seconds and keep working through it. Good. And once you've worked those calves, I really feel it on that side right there. And that's funny, because this is my left leg, and when I squat, my left ankle and foot turns out a little bit. And a lot of that's due to tightness in the calf. And so this one is way tighter than the other. And if you find one side to be a little tighter than the other, spend more time there. All right, so we're now gonna progress it up and move up the body to the hamstrings. Now, a couple of options here. Abby's gonna show you just sitting on the roller. You can just have one leg on the roller. You can have both. I don't know if you're gonna feel much there. Do you feel anything? She does, okay. If you're super sore and that's all you need, then you stay there. But she can go from this position where she's got one leg propped and she's rolling the other and applying pressure. Here's another option. This is one that I like to use. I'll use a bench or a chair or a stool, and I'll actually sit down. Now, if you've got a PVC roller like I have, this thing is slippery. So I'm gonna just put pressure here, and then I'm gonna straighten the leg and relax. So I'm just flexing at the knee and extending at the knee. And I can feel that. But if I need more intensity, I put together two lacrosse balls. You could do tennis balls, and then just taped them together. That's all I did here. I can apply pressure here. Oh, that, wow, okay, yeah, there you go. Uh-huh. That's the way I would go. Or grab one lacrosse ball. Abby, you wanna show them the one lacrosse ball? You can also use that and place it on the ground. These are just different ways to progress. How long again? She's feeling all that. 30 to 60 seconds of just finding hard, gnarly, tight spots and just mashing on it. Just taking that piece of meat and breaking it apart. She doesn't like when I say that. I don't know. She's like a tiger. Tiger King. I'm sorry. I watched a couple episodes. Don't do it to yourself. Don't do it. All right. So now I'm just switching to the other side. Again, some people may have more tightness right below the knee or right by the knee. Some it's farther up, working your way up to the glute. Some people have some pretty tough piriformis, and we'll talk about that too. All right, so now that we've done the hamstrings, we're gonna now move up to the glutes. Now, a lot of people sit on the roller just like this, But your glute fibers, check out this. Here you go. Glute fibers run this way. Yeah, one more time. Okay, so we're actually gonna turn the roller long ways, and I'm gonna put one butt cheek on it. And then Abby's just gonna hold from that position. She's gonna just roll across, massage. This is really just a good massage. But if you find a tight spot, you wanna hang out there. Now I'm gonna progress this up a little bit. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cross one leg over, and I'm gonna pray to the good Lord that I don't fall off the roller and people make fun of me. There you go. And then I'm just gonna roll all the way to the side of the hip, all the way to the center, right by the butt crack. That is the anatomical term, just so you know. Good, back and forth here until I find a tight spot. I found a tight spot here, so I'm just gonna hold. Whew. All right, and then you're gonna do the same on the other side. Timing is the same for this. If you can do a minute with each muscle group, I think you're gonna feel fantastic. Again, I want you to pay attention to, is one side sore than the other? Because it does, it means you have an imbalance, most likely. It means you're compensating in some way, and you can't always feel your compensations. If you do perform movements in a mirror, though, you might see that your body is shifting to one side or you're placing more weight on one side. And that's the benefit of doing single leg exercises, so you make sure you're not cheating and compensating. All right, now once you've worked the glute for a little while, we're gonna now move to the front of the body and go to the quads. All right, make sure you take that kind of V angle here. So Abby's gonna demonstrate just laying across the roller. A lot of times I see people's rollers slide out from underneath them. Just make sure you get in a good position. And she's gonna roll from the right above the knee to right below the hip and just work that quad muscle back and forth. So that's one way to do it there. And if your quads are super sore, that's gonna be plenty. But notice she's bending the legs. She's gonna flex back and forth. And that really helps break up that area. I like to do this prior to working out. If I know I'm doing squats, I'm most likely gonna do my calves and quads to make sure I have a good squat. Those are the two areas that I would focus on. But let's say we wanna amp this up a little bit. A couple of ways to do that. I'm gonna take one leg off the roller and just kind of support it with my foot and then roll across. And I'm gonna go inside, I'm gonna go outside and start that bend. And that's a lot harder. If you really wanna amp it up and you can handle it, you're gonna cross that leg over. And that's hard for me right now. I did do legs yesterday, so that's probably why I'm feeling so much of it. But if I can't, I'm gonna bend. But the key here is to be able to breathe through it. All right, so again, this is where I'd want you to pause, work that quad 60 seconds, and then switch, or if you've got both on there, just keep rolling. If you wanna go longer than 60, that's fine if it's feeling good. If it's hurting, I don't think anyone wants to go longer than that. All right, and then we're gonna take this position and now turn to the side, and we're gonna roll out the IT band a little bit. And we're gonna show you two ways to do this. First is with the roller, and this is the least effective way. It can create a little bit of improvement temporarily, and then you're gonna bend that leg. And a lot of people will find tightness here. If you are a runner, or let's say you have outside knee pain that you feel here, it's often attributed to the IT band pulling on it. But there's another muscle that's really involved, which we're gonna show you in just a minute how we're gonna handle that. So the TFL is the culprit for a lot of the outside knee pain and IT band tightness. So really, if you can address that muscle, you're probably gonna be in your best situation. So you can use either a lacrosse ball, tennis ball, anything that's round, anything you can find that you can really just rest right here. So we're gonna rest it right here on the side. And again, this tight muscle gets overworked. It's usually gonna get overworked because our glutes are not firing. And that's a very important thing that we do at B3. We really want to activate our glutes. But if we can loosen this up and relax this and then start to work on strengthening our glutes, you're going to get rid of a lot of that outside knee pain and pain on the side of the knee. So for a lot of people, laying on it is all you need. But once you find it, some people need to take a little time to find it. But once you find it, right there. Yep, done. Even for me, sometimes when I'm on it, I can feel like a tingling. You're going to feel tingling. Now, if you can move that leg, and that'll help break it up a little bit. This is good to do prior to exercise, but if I'm just doing it, and I'm gonna hold for 60 seconds and just hang out on it, and just try to relax and calm that muscle down. And we calm the muscle down so we can either stretch it or activate it. That's one or the other is what we're looking for. Activate an opposing muscle. All right, so once you've spent about 60 seconds there, again, you can pause the video, hang out and hold. We'll switch to the other side. Bow, 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 bow. Oh yeah, that's really what you need for a rolling video, is sound effects. I got you back, guys. Oh yeah, oh that's good. No faces. There you go. Good, again, about 60 seconds. Let the world just disappear. Go into a nice, dark, quiet room. Soft blankets, pillows, no? Just me?
Right. Just you.
Okay. Now this is the last muscle that we're going to hit, and then we're gonna move to the upper body. You ready to move to the upper body? Okay, we're gonna move to the T-spine. First thing I'm gonna show you is a real simple way. Abby's gonna show you a real simple way to roll out the T-spine. She's just gonna lay across the pipe. Now, if your pipe slides out, you're probably gonna wanna tuck your thumbs inside the holes. While she's doing that, I'm gonna show you another way that we like to do it, placing it long ways and then just laying across it. It can feel a little awkward, especially at first, but you have your tailbone right there on the edge of the pipe. I'm gonna lay back. And the first thing I'm gonna do is make sure my head can hit the ground. And I'm just gonna open up, let gravity take over. We live in a really rounded world where our shoulders are rounded. We're on phones and iPads and driving and eating, shoveling food into our mouth. Oh my God, I'm hungry. Here we're just gonna open up. And Abby's really just gonna roll across, and she can go side to side. She can cross her arms. She can put her hands back behind her head. Me, I'm gonna hold out this position. And then what I can do is I can go into some snow angels and break that area up. I can also go into some scarecrows and moving. And I can do one side at a time if it bothers my neck, or I can again just rest my neck on the ground. Now, if you wanna progress that up, this might be too easy if you've been doing this for a while. You can use a peanut. So this one's great. You just put it right between the spine and right where the shoulder blades are. You can go anywhere from the mid bra area, which, you know, all mine are in the wash today. We can go between the shoulder blade and all the way down mid back. Oh, just rolling, but make sure you can breathe through it. Then we can also work the arms, go through the snow angels and the scarecrows, and then just move and make big circles and break that area up. How's that feeling? Good, okay. So that's really breaking up the T-spine. I'd spend a lot of time there. When you're rounded, a couple things that happen. You have a really tight pecs, but your T-spine gets weak, but it's also stiff. It's how your body compensates. It makes areas, muscles stiff, so that way it's not super loose and unstable and you can get hurt. So it'll tighten it up. So we wanna break that area up. So now we're gonna shift gears here, and we're gonna go back to the roller, and we're gonna hit the lats. This is an area that's really hard for a lot of people. Best way to hit the lats are to get your armpit, start with your armpit sideways, and then start to shift your weight back slightly and grab that chunk of meat that's right here. Chunk of meat, she hates when I say that. Chunk of meat, get that chunk of meat. Come on, get that ground round, is that what it is? Yeah, there you go. And now you can also start moving your arm in this position once you find those tight areas, but that's a progression that may take a little bit of time because the lats are usually really tight for people. But you can again go back to a lacrosse ball or homemade peanut, put it in the same area, and the smaller the object, the more intense it's gonna be because it really pinpoints certain areas. And then you can just move your arm. Now, if you're able to, you can lift your hip up and work through it, but that's hard for a lot of folks. So you can just start with your legs down and just shifting and moving and grooving. Get it. There you go. Pause the video, massage it out, or go along with my sound effects. Oh yeah, oh that's good. Yep. Make sure though you are breathing through it. And we call it belly breathing, where you fill up your belly instead of filling up your chest. All right, then you would switch to the other side. What we're gonna do is move to another area that's tight, which is the front of the body, the chest and the shoulders. So Abby's gonna grab the peanut and she's gonna start on the pec. So you can go anywhere from the armpit around here. Now, anatomically speaking, this is easy for me, but if you are a different gender than I am and you have areas built different than mine, this may bother you. So if it does, go up to a wall and lean into the wall and break up this area, okay? This area gets tight, the lats get tight, it pulls the arms down, pulls the shoulders forward. So we're gonna do the pec, but we can also do the shoulder. So I'm gonna do the shoulder on the ground, but I recommend against the wall because that's a lot of weight to put on the shoulder. And then we can just break it up. So I'm actually just going to keep my hips on the ground and massage, find tight spots. When I find it, hang out. Then if I can, I can lean into it if I can handle it. But I want to be able to breathe through it. Here you go. So she's rolling the pec. I'm rolling the shoulder. 30 to 60 seconds each time. I can't say that enough. If we're doing before you work out, that's where I would spend the same amount of time, but I do active movements with it. All right, we ready to move to the pipe? Okay, so we're gonna move to the pipe. You can use a broomstick at home. You can use a band. You can use a towel. You can use a bathrobe belt. Doesn't matter. She's gonna go from kneeling position. I'm gonna go from standing position. So you're gonna take a wide position with your hands. Start really, really wide because we're not sure what your mobility is here. Then you're gonna touch either your hip bone, your waistline, somewhere in that area, and keep the arms super straight. These are your elbow pits. We're gonna point the elbow pits up to the sky and keep them pointed up as we bring it back under control and either touch your waistline or hips. Now, if that was super easy, that's where you're gonna slide your hands in just a little bit. A tiny bit goes a long way here. So if you slide too much and then you feel like, oh goodness, I gotta bend my arms, then that's not where I want you to be. I want you to keep your arms straight. And if you feel like when you're doing this, one side wants to cave in on you, you may have some shoulder blade issues there, so be aware of that. Take your time, nice and slow, 30 to 60 seconds, of just opening up. Then you can also do one side at a time and get really funky and creative with it. There you go. This is one of those things, what I would just walk around my neighborhood and just do this as people walk by. But remember my rule, if you make eye contact with somebody, you cannot break that eye contact. That is very important. All right, and this is a good way just to break up this whole area. All right, so now we're gonna move back down to the lower body. And this is where we would do stretching. Now there's two types of stretching that we normally do. It's either active or static stretching. Active is prior to exercising. And this is for us about a 3 to 5 second hold most of the time. Static stretching is after exercising or on a day that you're not exercising because it lengthens the muscles temporarily and that weakens those muscles temporarily and it puts you at risk of an injury. So be aware of that. So the first stretch we're gonna do is the ankle stretch or dorsiflexion stretch. This is one of the biggest factors on a poor squat because people do not have, they have very stiff ankles, very tight calves. It's just the way that we live today. So she is driving that knee forward, applying pressure, keeping the heel down, and her knees should be driving over her little toes, not over the big toe. A simple way to cheat this movement is to drive that knee in. That's a mistake. Now, if being down on your knee bothers you, you can do it from a standing position, and we can just drive forward, keep that heel planted. And if I were doing this facing a wall in a kneeling position, pretending this is the wall, I want to be about a fist length away from the wall. And then I want to practice just driving that knee as far forward, trying to touch that wall with that heel being down. And that's good mobility. That should be your goal. So I would just find out where that spot is and practice from there. All right, so again, 30 to 60 seconds with the ankles. Now we're going to move up a little bit and go into stretching the hip flexors, and then we'll do the quads. So with the hip flexor, I'm going to do it from a standing position. She's going to do it from a kneeling. First thing you got to do is tighten your butt. You got to tighten your glute, the one that's down. So either poke it, make sure it's tight, or put your finger right there, right in here, and squeeze and lock it, and then you'll know. Am I right?
Yeah.
Now go wash your hands. Okay. So now you're going to lean in. Lean in. So she squeezed the glute, she's leaning in, and she can feel that pull on the leg that's down. But then she can amplify it a little bit by lifting that arm up and kind of rotating and turning across and getting an even deeper pull on her hip flexor. This is probably going to be one of the most important stretches for 90% of the people. Now, how would I do that from a standing position? If you want, go ahead and switch. But I'll show you from a standing position. So from a standing position, everything stays true. I want to squeeze the glute. Now it's tight. Whoop. Then lean in, driving my hips forward. And I can reach up and rotate across and really feel that pull. So that would be a good way to do it for a standing position if being on your knees bothers you. Again, 30 seconds on that. Now we're going to go into a quad stretch. Abby's going to show you how we do the quad stretch. Very similar to the hip flexor stretch, except now we're going to pull that foot in. If you can't quite do that, you can always elevate that back foot on a couch or on a stool or on some kind of ball or something that elevates it. If kneeling bothers you, I'm going to do it from a standing position. Actually, I'll do it on this side. You just need something that'll help you keep your balance. And then when I grab my leg, for me, I have limited mobility from knee replacement, so I'm going to reach down and grab right in the front, right by the ankle, and pull back. Now, a lot of people will bring that leg out. I don't feel that stretch. When I feel that stretch is when I tuck the knee in, and right there, I can really feel it pull. So that's how you would stretch that quad from a standing position, 30 to 60 seconds. All right, and then we're gonna go to one more stretch in the lower body before we go to the upper body, and this is a glute stretch. Have you wanna get, I'm gonna get flat here. So what we'll do is bend both legs. You're gonna take one leg and cross it over. Whatever leg you cross over is the glute that you're stretching. Now, you've created a little triangle through here. So she's gonna reach through with one hand, grab the front of her knee. She's gonna grab, lock that hand in, and now she's gonna lay back and rest her head and breathe. And every time you exhale, I want you to try to pull a little bit more. All right, now if you don't think they're pulling, you can be a partner and you can drive them a little bit and they'll feel that, and that'll really stretch out the glute. And you'll go, again, 30 to 60 seconds, just breathing, keeping it under control, then switching, going to the other side, same thing. All right, good. So there's your lower body stretching. Hope that's helpful. We're gonna go to the upper body now. We're gonna start with thread the needle. So we thread the needle. First thing we do is we take our knees out really, really wide. This makes your hips stay stable and in one place so they can't cheat. Now from here, she's going to slip one arm through and drop that shoulder down. If you're doing a static stretch, she's just gonna hold for 30 seconds or 60 seconds. If she's going active, she's gonna hold for about 3 to 5 and then go into the T-spine stretch where she reaches up and she's opening up the chest and really getting that area nice and mobile. Again, for static, just hang out and hold. And then hold that position and keep breathing through it. Belly breathe, fill that belly up. All right, if her knees were closer together, her hips would rotate. And so it would kind of cheat a little bit. So you want to really take that wide position. Good, you doing okay there?
Yeah.
All right, good. All right, so that's a great upper body stretch to incorporate as well. We're gonna do one more. Can you grab that roller? This is a good lat stretch, also the shoulders. So we call this a prayer stretch. Do you wanna demonstrate from the side for them, all right? So she's gonna kind of sit back on the heels a little bit, and then she's just blading and dropping her head as low as she can. Now, if you can drop a whole lot lower than that, you can elevate from a bench, and now you can get really super deep. But this is stretching her lats and her shoulders. And if it's an active stretch, then she would just hold for 3 to 5, she'd roll her hands back, come back up, and she'd roll right back down again. Good, and this is good to just do, and anytime you're not exercising or prior to any, you know, big upper body workout, it's good to get these areas nice and mobile. Feel good? Good, okay. So just to recap real quick, guys. Prior to any lunging, squatting, any of those types of positions, if I had to pick two areas to focus on, the two areas that would make the biggest for me would be making sure my calves are taken care of, and then that quad area up here isn't too tight. That's gonna allow me to really get more glutes, and I'm gonna get deeper in my squat without having to lean forward and cheat with my squat. When it comes to the upper body, I'd have to say the T-spine. People have a huge problem with T-spine. It becomes stiff and they're rounded. That would be the area. Focusing on breaking up the T-spine and then doing what we call face pulls, where you're actually pulling a band towards your face so you're strengthening your T-spine. But if you have any questions, guys, just leave a comment, ask them, let us know. We are here to help, and that's what we want to do, is help everyone out there in the fitness community.